Greetings, everyone. Many of you are familiar with the 4x100W Bluetooth amplifier board JAB5, as it can be used in various audio system setups. JAB5 not only functions in 4.0, 2.1, or 2.0 modes on its own, but also offers an I2S digital signal output for connecting to other amplifier boards to expand audio systems. For instance, if someone desires a high-power 2.1 system, especially with a powerful subwoofer, this interface can be utilized. In today's video, we will demonstrate how to use JAB5 in conjunction with a high-power single-channel amplifier board from WONDOM to create a high-power 2.1 audio system, using a 1x500W TAMP amplifier board as an example. Since this single-channel high-power amplifier board only supports analog input, we need to use a digital signal conversion board to convert the I2S signal output from JAB5 into an analog signal. Here, we employ the PCM5122 D2A I2S to analog signal conversion board for this purpose. Furthermore, the I2S signal provided by JAB5 is a stereo full-range signal, and the single-channel high-power amplifier board is a full-range amplifier. To drive the subwoofer, we need to process the stereo full-range I2S signal output by JAB5 and Sigma Studio into a mixed bass signal. For demonstration purposes, we have pre-configured the program with a low-pass filter set at 180 Hz. You can adjust this cutoff frequency according to your subwoofer specifications. Additionally, we have modified the four external potentiometers on JAB5 to control high, mid, and bass gains, along with a master volume switch. Due to resource constraints in the ADAU1701 DSP, we have removed programs related to the automatic mode detection switch on JAB5. Therefore, if you wish to build a 2.1 system using the single-channel high-power amplifier board, you can use this program. If you later want to restore JAB5 to its default functionality, you will need to reload the default program. As this system incorporates JAB5, PCM5122 I2S to analog signal conversion board, and a single-channel high-power amplifier board, signal matching between the products is crucial. The default maximum signal output amplitude of the PCM5122 I2S to analog signal conversion board is 0.88 VRMS with 4 gain levels provided. You can adjust the gain level to suit the input sensitivity of the single-channel high-power amplifier board. The amplifier board used here has an input sensitivity of 1.8 VRMS, so the PCM5122 I2S to analog signal conversion board is set at 6 dB. Furthermore, since each product has different power supply voltages, multiple power sources will be used in the system. Ground loops may arise between these power sources, leading to ground noise. It is recommended to connect the negative terminals of the power outputs using a thick black wire to avoid ground noise. For demonstration purposes, we are using the same 36 volts power supply to power both JAB5 and the single-channel amplifier. Let's proceed with the demonstration. Step 1, write the prepared program to JAB5. Step 2, set up the system. Configure the gain of the PCM5122 signal conversion board to 6 dB. Use a 6-pin cable to connect the I2S output port of JAB5 to the I2S input port of the PCM5122 converter. Then plug a 3.5mm audio cable into the single-ended output port of the PCM5122, connecting the other end to the input port of the 500W TAMP amplifier board. Since the signal has been configured as a mixed signal in Sigma Studio, only one RCA connection is necessary. Finally, power on the system. Let's listen and see how it performs.
I don't know what you want. Let's have a bit of fun till I downfall. My love, if you feel like I do right now, don't say you're on the run to the other side. My love.
you found this video helpful, please kindly consider liking, sharing, or leaving a comment. Thank you for your support and valuable feedback.